What would be a smart step for Khan if he comes back? You think he should take a soft touch, or should he jump in there with like
Danny Garcia? He fought a tough fight. He got knocked out ugly. You know, he shouldn't go. I wouldn't recommend him to go back in with a puncher. You know, he should probably
Danny's mandatory.
Oh yeah, yeah. I wouldn't recommend. I'm saying Khan's a good boxer, man. It's just, you know, I give him a lot of credit for going up in weight.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Give him a lot of credit.
Keith Thurman recently said that Danny Garcia is kind of cherry picking in that his power didn't really travel up to him with him from 140. What do you think about that, man? Like, what's a good?
You can't call Danny Garcia a cherry picker. That's ridiculous. He wasn't supposed to be Khan, right? He wasn't supposed to be Khan. He was put in that fight to lose.
Matisse too.
Yeah, you know, they were, you know, the promotion was all behind Khan, and it was all about Khan, and it was disrespectful to Danny because Danny was actually the champion. But Khan was getting treated like the champion in that fight, I remember, you know. So Khan, you know, Danny knocks him out. And then Danny goes and he's the underdog facing Matisse. And Matisse is knocking everyone out, right? Mm-hmm. And Danny gives him a boxing lesson and even drops him. You know, and then he goes and he beats Lamont Peterson. I was ringside at that fight. Was it tough for him down the stretch? It really was. But he won a lot of them early rounds. You know, so I did give him that fight. So you talking Lamont Peterson, Matisse, Khan.
Who are the top guys at 147 you think Danny has the best shot against?
I think Danny has a shot at any of those guys. Uh-huh. I could see. Because see, the thing is, I know Danny personally. You know what I'm saying? Me and Danny, when I was actually smaller, we used to work, right? You know, when I fought at 54, me and Danny would spar. We would prepare each other for our fights, you know? And we would spar. And one thing about Danny is he just has, like, that mentality of he's not going to lose. You know what I'm saying? So that's the thing about Danny. Listen, you might, you know, there might be other guys in the division that have probably better skills than Danny, but the thing is, boxing consists of how strong is your mind, you know what I'm saying? And Danny's the type of guy where you might be faster than him, as Khan was, you know what I'm saying? And you might have better skills, but Danny's gonna find a way to land that big punch, and he's gonna find a way to work his way to win a fight.
Do you think his chin's underrated?
Oh yeah, he got a great chin. You know, Matisse hit him. I think there was one part in that round where he knocked the mouthpiece went flying. Mm-hmm. And, you know, Dan took that shot. So Dan has a good chin. He has the will and the skill. So, you know, I think, he can be anybody in the 47 division.
Can you take that will in with Mayweather, man? Because there's rumor that, you know, if it's not McGregor, if it's not Pacquiao rematch, then Danny's the likely candidate.
Listen, if Floyd does come back, I would like to see him and Danny. That's a fight I would like to see, because Danny's an undefeated champion in two different weight classes, you know. And like I said, Floyd might have the more experience and the skill level, but Dan's not gonna go in that fight just for a paycheck. Like, Dan's gonna go in that fight, he's gonna try to win. And that's what makes good fights, when a guy actually wants to win, not a guy that's just going in there because he wants to get paid. Because a lot of guys call Floyd out, but they don't really believe they could beat Floyd. They just want that check. You know, you've never heard Danny call Floyd out. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Danny always says, oh, well, they want to fight, then all right. But Dan, you never hear Danny saying, yo, Floyd.
Nope.
Because Dan's mentality is, I'm a champion, and I'm a do things my way. And if that fight happens, it happens. But my career doesn't depend on Floyd. So he's not doing what everyone else is doing, where they just want to get that check, you know? So that's what makes the fight interesting, is that if Dan fights Floyd, he's actually going to try to win. You know what I'm saying?